Because playing football, as you know, it will find a way for you to succeed if you do what Drew Brees just said, if you're willing to work at it. Think about how you, as a football player, by position, by quarterback, Drew Brees, can find a way even in that one position. We've heard quarterback be termed system quarterback. We've heard gunslinger. We've heard mobile. We've heard pocket passer. All inclusive. So the thing about basketball, baseball, other sports, to me, you get exposed easy in those sports. Easily you are exposed because of genetics, lottery, et cetera. Football is going to say if you do win the genetics lottery, you're in prime position. But if you don't, here's this consolation prize. Here's this other way to approach this game. Every position has it. You can look at a defensive lineman like myself. Are you an edge rusher? Or you're a run stopper? Or you're a two-gapper? We find ways for you to succeed because football is a great game of skill and a greater game of will. In other sports, you can half-heart it. In basketball, somebody hits you, ouch, two free throws, okay, cool times. In football, you go out there half-hearted. The next play after someone knocks your head off, you're going to realize, do I want this or not? Obviously, Drew Brees, throughout his career, from day one, and I saw him play day one, to right now, eclipsing all these records, he wants it, and he shows that will.
I think, and again, I'm a homer for football, but it's the ultimate test of will, like you said. It's the ultimate test of man. And look, people hear this when I've said this in the past. They hear it as a great shot at LeBron James. Mm. It's really not a shot at LeBron James. LeBron James won the genetics lottery, but he also has the work ethic of any of the greatest athletes of all time.
Big time.
But what I've tried to say is, you know what failure for LeBron would look like? And I've said this and people have misunderstood it. But if LeBron had been a failure, if he hadn't tried and given his best effort in basketball, he would be Michael Beasley, guy that played in the league for a long time, made $40 million.
Yeah.
I don't really care how talented you are. If you don't try in football, you're going to get hurt. You're going to be out of the league real quickly.
Yeah.
You can't fake it. You can't cut every corner and still be a money-making, competitive NFL football player. It just can't happen. There's no place to hide.
No place to hide except on the bench. And even then, that gets lonely, and then you find yourself, like you said, out of the game. It's crazy because football presents every single play a new wall that you have to run through. You can try at a younger level, at a younger age, to hop the walls, athleticism. Hey, if you're fast at age 8, you're going to be the best player on the team. I don't give a damn if you know football or not. You get to high school, if you still got those athletic talents, they will take you far, college as well. And then you hit this level. And when that wall is presented, Drew Brees, when he injures his shoulder, almost tears it off. Drew Brees, when they're saying, we're going to draft at your position, there's a Phillip Rivers here. Drew Brees, when he's declined his medical evaluation and passing it with Miami. Drew Brees, when he gets to New Orleans and they're still wearing the paper bags. You have to run through those walls, and Drew Brees is a perfect example of one who does.
We're going to transition to a second layer, but I want to give you an opportunity to answer this question. It's one I've just thought of in a moment. There's a lot of comment, who's the greatest quarterback? And I think most people agree Drew Brees isn't in that debate. He's not there with Brady and Manning and some of the other guys. But when I put it to you this way, Marcellus, and when I was writing this and thinking about this last night and this morning, Drew Brees may be the football player and the quarterback I respect the most.
And that respect comes from?
Just the totality. Yeah. Being the undersized guy, gets hurt in San Diego, reinvents himself in New Orleans, embodies everything about New Orleans, puts together this incredible career. And what's the knock? There's no knock. There's no Make America Great hat in his locker for anybody to pick at. And I really don't have a problem with Brady for that, but some people do.
Yeah.
Drew Brees has been in this limelight for 15 to 18 years, spotless.
Yeah, and I saw him from day one. Obviously, he was drafted as a rookie when I was a San Diego Charger as well. And a lot of people want to give him tremendous respect as he deserves. But a lot of people take it too far when they say he's overachieved. I don't think that Drew Brees has overachieved. I think that the evaluation system has failed us to the point where we think this is an overachievement because we're not properly using the right scope. Now, what is that scope? To measure, like you said, his will, to measure his heart, that tenacity, and to stay out of harm's way off the field as well. Drew Brees being 5'11", But those accuracy, the way that he's so accurate and the way that he gets the ball to the proper receivers, how he diagnoses the defense, we need to find a system and a measurement that respects how guys approach the game in those capacities instead of the old traditional way, how tall you are, how far can you throw it, and you get lazy with those evaluations.
All right, but it also raises a somewhat legitimate question when he talks about he held the record for 1,000 days. He knows Drew's going to break the touchdown passing record, he or Peyton Manning or Tom Brady at some point. And I just wonder, Marcellus, if the new rules around quarterback play in the NFL, does it diminish these passing records at all?
Oh, it absolutely does. And you have to look at these new rules and say, okay, let's respect the previous era without making the error of disrespecting these players currently and their greatness. Drew Brees is going to benefit from a receiver who can't get touched after 5 yards. He's going to benefit from a more protected pocket. But as we see these new rules occur, we're seeing these numbers get inflated to a point where if you don't dive deeper into the numbers, you're going to see things like an all-time quarterback ranking and rating. You're going to see Tony Romo fifth. And you're going to say, that's higher than Steve Young. Interesting. Then you're going to see a Kirk Cousins that's ninth. That's higher than Joe Montana. Interesting. And right behind Joe Montana is Chad Pennington and Matt Schaub. Like, these numbers are getting so inflated right now, but I don't want to make the error of not respecting greatness when I see it. And Drew Brees is greatness no matter what era that is.
You know, you said in the previous discussion about evaluating guys in the draft process differently. I almost think we're going to have to come up with a different way to evaluate great quarterback play.
Yeah.
Because I think it's going to get reduced down to just Super Bowls. How many Super Bowls did you win?
Yeah, right.
And we need, I don't know if it's touchdowns to interceptions because guys are throwing a lot less interceptions now. I don't know what the stat is or what the key measure, maybe it's third down efficiency. I don't know. But I just don't think Matt Stafford, I think, is on pace to eventually be the all-time passer, yards leader. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be hard to put him in the same category as Drew Brees, Peyton Manning, Brett Favre, the people that have held this, Fran Tarkenton, the people that have held this record previously. We're going to have to look for a new measurement and a way to evaluate these quarterbacks because it has been made so comfortable in the pocket. No one has to have the kind of fear you used to have when you played from the pocket. I don't know. I legitimately don't know. I'm at a loss how we're going to statistically evaluate quarterbacks in the future moving forward.
And you know what? That's not on us. The deeper dive into analytics and all that progression, where that's heading, it happened in baseball, and it's happened in baseball where you talk about batting average. And you used to sit around at the sports bar and say somebody batting average. Oh, man, he's good. And then somebody's like, what's his OPS? You're like, what'd you just say? You know, UPS. Like, you don't even understand where they're coming from. We have to take a deeper dive into these numbers. I think we're on track to realizing in the transition of eras, there has to be a deeper number than just touchdowns, just interceptions. You have to look at a Drew Brees and say, with that accuracy, which is the best all time, he can play anywhere. But then you have to look at some of these other guys, a Chad Pennington sitting there right by a Joe Montana in some major statistical category and say, that's a problem. We have to take a deeper dive.
All right.